With the advent of the jet age in the 1940s and 50s, the velocity of aircraft was fast approaching the speed of sound, making it readily apparent that construction techniques for jet aircraft would require significant changes to meet new and unforeseen operational demands. And the Air Force Office of Scientific Research was ready for the challenge. Since its founding in 1951, AFOSR has maintained an active research program in aircraft structures and materials. This program must constantly evolve, addressing revolutionary advances in aerodynamics. One such revolutionary technology, funded in the 1970s and 80s, resulted in a now commonly used technique to increase the strength and resistance of metal alloys for airframes. With minimal tooling and machining requirements, superplastic forming allows the production of very strong, very complex shapes at drastically reduced costs. Presently, AFOSR, a directorate of the Air Force Research Laboratory, is concentrating on finding and funding the best materials researchers in the world. Their mission: to develop new nanomaterials that will have revolutionary impacts on the future Air Force. In a premier facility at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, Dr. Rich Vaya and his team are developing new classes of nanostructured and biological materials, taking functionality that exists in nature and using new ways to combine them with traditional materials.
We're working on new materials that solve a large number of very important and very exciting problems. Everywhere from energy storage, being able to make batteries and capacitors smaller so that our weapon systems are more agile, to sensors that will be able to monitor human performance and enable the warfighter to be better prepared for his or her missions. Effectively, we're creating what you can think of as Lego blocks that we can put together in different arrays and different forms to create materials with different properties.
One high-priority Air Force innovation targeted in this program is improving the efficiency of capacitors, enabling aircraft to have more usable space, less weight, and lower energy consumption.
Reducing the capacitor, increasing its performance is critical for so many different types of objectives, not only with the Air Force, but also improving energy storage gives us a benefit to the environment in the future as well.
My enjoyment of doing fundamental research pretty much boils down to the challenge of taking science fiction and making it science fact. The challenges that are facing both now and future Air Force capability needs, and being able to marriage that what if with the what do you need, is where the real excitement comes.
A similarly impressive team at the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign has created and transitioned a process in which materials can autonomously heal themselves when damage occurs without any human intervention. This basic research is particularly relevant to the Air Force, which requires superior performance from its aerospace vehicles and weapons systems, demonstrating great promise for a new class of composite materials that can offer autonomic or involuntary responses to damage.
They accomplish this by incorporating small microcapsules that contain a liquid phase healing agent throughout the material itself. Whenever damage occurs, those capsules are ruptured. The liquid phase inside is then released into the fracture damage, undergoes a chemical reaction in situ, and recovers mechanical integrity that way.
Regardless of the material types, super water repellent surfaces, lightweight durable coatings modeled after pearl, self-healing plastics, or nanostructures of smaller aircraft components, AFOSR stays on the cutting edge of scientific research, always in search of the next game-changing material for the Air Force, and continues to fund the pioneering work of revolutionary researchers around the world. Learn more about U.S. Air Force-funded material science projects by visiting our websites, www.afrl.af.mil, and www.afosr.af.mil. Like us on Facebook, watch us on YouTube, or follow us on Twitter.